What the fuck?
Co-op.
Aw, shit.
My favorite game of all time. You'd think it'd be Zelda. You'd be wrong.
Yeah, I mean, like, I originally thought...
Isn't that weird? I have Zelda tattoos, but this game is my favorite game.
I thought you liked Majora's Mask as your favorite. I know it's your favorite Zelda, but...
Zelda's my favorite series, but Nights into Dreams is my favorite game.
Yes, just in case you couldn't catch it, this is Nights into Dreams, originally released on the Sega Saturn.
So, there's story in there. She wants to audition to this musical.
Really?
And her story, which will play second...
Oh, no.
I'm sorry, we'll play her story first.
She's having a nightmare.
She's having a nightmare.
That she thinks she won't be able to do it. She's getting nervous. Wow.
And she has to conquer her nightmare.
Wow. That is a little bit traumatic. Conquer your nightmare. Wow, that's fucked up. Okay. Originally released on... Oh, man, that's
she has
sad.
To conquer her nightmare to be able to have the courage when she comes back to actually go through with it.
Now, Nights into Dreams... I mean, we're playing on this on PC because it was released.
Demo. Now we're at the demo.
So,
That didn't actually show us the cutscene that I wanted to show off there. It was just kind of an intro to her. Other character you can play as, Elliot, he wants to play basketball.
Okay.
His story's a lot less interesting.
So we're going to play...
Until you add in Claris.
We're going to play the remastered version, right?
Yes. The only difference is that the graphics are better. Now, so we're going to start with Claris, and then we'll play Elliot's story. And they kind of mishmash.
Matt is going to be playing this, because it's his game.
I'm really good at it.
I mean, I own it, but it's his favorite game.
We're not going to go for the best score, because it'll take a little longer.
Yeah.
We're going to go for just clearing the stages with C rank as fast as possible and get to the final stage.
All right.
And I'll kind of explain a little bit of the backstory of things that we're doing.
This
there's a little bit of story
definitely
here.
Definitely looks better.
You see those things spinning around her?
Yes.
Those are called idea.
Idea.
They
okay.
represent aspects of the human soul, which are like, I think one of them is knowledge, passion, aspiration, I think?
So,
but this red one is the only one that they can't take from a person, and that's the idea of
that's
courage.
That's a weird-ass walking animation.
If you want to be pro at this game, instead of going and getting knights right away, you pick up these blue chips.
Okay.
You can actually pick up enough blue chips in the first stage before getting to knights to open up this thing.
Okay.
So you
mad
just
pro.
Like immediately go into bonus time and rack up mad high score.
Nice.
I'll use this method this time for this stage, but we're not going to do it every stage.
Oh, you can triple jump. That's
yeah, you
nice.
Can triple jump.
That's cool. Because really, I don't know much about Knights. The most thing I know about this is that I know Yuji Naka made it, and Yuji Naka is, you know, Mr. Sonic. He's the guy who made Sonic, and he's the guy who bailed on Sonic 06 before it was released, pretty much saying, yeah, I can't even fix this shit. Get my name off this. But, I know that, this is one of those Sega series that really sort of solidified
Sega. It kind
of fell
into obscurity. It's kind
of it
weird.
Did, because for a while before...
It's really good.
Before it was re-released... This was one of a pretty hard to find game because it was a Saturn game, but a lot of people said that, you know, this is one of the best games ever, and it's really good that they eventually released it, because up till then, you really only saw Knights as sort of...
We're just gonna go ahead and get Knights.
Knights sort of as a cameo character in Sonic games, and I didn't know who he was because I saw, like, in Sonic Adventure 2 Battle, you can play as, you know, you see Knights there, and I'm like, who's Knights? And I'm like, oh, that's Knights, so... So... Like, this is still a very, very impressive demonstration of the animation. I mean, this really moves in a very creative way.
Bonus time begin.
So you can... I know that when this was released, it was released a special Sega Saturn controller that had an analog stick. The original Sega Saturn did not have an analog stick on the controller. But this was the game that said, yeah, we gotta get an analog stick. Not Sonic 3D Blast. This.
Well, Sonic 3D Blast controls isometrically. You don't need a...
Well, I heard the analog stick actually makes it control better.
Really?
You know, not perfectly, but it's... Yeah.
So basically, you float around these tracks, and the goal is to get the link as high as possible. Kind of fucked that one up.
For mad points.
So instead of going... If I go into that thing that I picked Knights up from... Shit, I fucked that up again. It's hard to, like, talk and do this at the same time. It's actually pretty tough. But the goal...
Oh, you collect the spheres by circling them around.
Go into the loops. Yeah, 18 Link. All right, we'll just go ahead and go in. But basically, I could have gotten an A if I had continued doing bonus time.
Yeah, we're just kind of...
The goal is C rank. You have to get C rank in every course to get... access to the final boss fight.
I mean, right now, the...
Oops, I didn't mean to do that.
Okay.
Oh, well. We got five more.
Right now, the game's models really aren't that impressive, but in motion, this looks really good. And before... But this has been on quite a few, you know, best game of all times lists that I've seen. It really was a cult hit before it got re-released, because not very many people have played it, not very many people even knew what Knights was.
There's even this game... And it's Knightopian system. Knightopians are those little angel creatures you see floating around in every stage.
This looks great. This is a really good-looking game.
Yeah. So the thing with the Knightopians is they're basically the precursor to Chao Gardens. They inspire
them. Yeah, that's
that.
True. This looks really good. Oops, really stylish. There's a lot of stuff going on, and I can kind of understand. Oh, I got an achievement. But just not a... being able to track everything on screen, because there's a lot of sensory overload.
There is. In all the stages, there are these eggs that have Knightopians in them.
Mm-hmm.
You can rescue them, and then they'll show up in your menu, and you can actually treat them differently. Like, you can burn them with your loop, paraloop is what it's called.
Yeah.
And if you do that... the music changes in the stage depending on how the Knightopians regard you.
That's cool. That's a nice little touch.
Yeah. Gives you a little extra ambience.
Woohoo! Just a roller coaster.
Kinda.
This game, you know,
it has a real feel-good game.
It has that Sonic sort of vibe. It's very, very motion-driven. It's all about moving.
What the fuck hit me?
Minus five.
Yeah, whenever you take damage... Oh, that fucker hit me.
Oh, that was
whenever you take damage in this game, it hits your time, which really hurt because...
If you're going for a higher rank.
Yeah, the score system is time-based.
Yeah. Like, this would take me a lot of practice.
I have 18 seconds down now.
Yeah, but...
You know, but that's okay. We're not going for high score. We're going for completion in this particular playthrough. Maybe we'll come back and do like a bonus episode.
Maybe.
Way down the line. But we'll come back and try it out. So if I run out of time during a course, what'll happen is I will immediately like get an F rank.
Yeah.
And Knights can only stay dualized with Claris for so long.
Mm-hmm.
So Claris will drop out of him, and that alarm clock monster that we kind of saw at the beginning of the stage will try and wake her up. And you don't want her to wake up. She has to dream. Gotta confront the nightmare first.
And Knights is not male or female.
No, he has no gender.
He's androgynous?
Yep.
Asexual? I don't know.
He's asexual, I guess. I don't know. He's an idea. He's a thought.
Yeah.
So those monsters are called Nightmarin, and they're what give people nightmares.
Mm-hmm.
Knights is a Nightmarin.
Yeah. Just a good nightmare.
Yeah, he's Wise Man the Wicked's right-hand man, but he doesn't... He's the final boss.
Are you going into a lot of different parts of this sort of world that you're in right now?
Each one of those loops was a different course. And the goal was to get each of those idea back that the monsters took at the beginning. So here's the first boss. I think his name's Gullwing.
Because it didn't seem like you were going in the same area
of the world over and over again.
It was pretty cool. This game is just so energetic. I mean, it feels like a roller coaster.
That's why the stages are like...
I feel like this might have been an influence for how 3D Sonic would eventually become, as far as, you know, lots of movement, lots of cinematic camera angles. Although this, it seems like you're doing a lot of the controlling yourself. It's not like, you know, going through pre-configured loops. It seems hard to control for me. It may take some time getting used to it.
It's not. It's actually a lot easier than I'm making it look.
That's good. That's a sign of good control. Yeah, there's lots of colors in this. After this, we should play Knight's Journey of Dreams.
the game mechanically is the same, but like a sequel, it adds some new features. Knights has more transformations. We'll see a couple transformations in this playthrough. I'll turn into Mermaid Knights for a while. I'll turn into Sled Knights.
Well, I know you don't like Journey of Dreams.
No, I like Journey of Dreams. It's great. The problem with that game is voice acting, which is the downfall of a lot.
Yeah, don't let Knights talk. Knights needs to
Knights,
shut his mouth.
Knights is actually a bad guy, but instead of making dreamers have nightmares like Wise Man wants him to do, he goes out and finds people struggling in nightmares and helps them.
I hated that all in Knight's Journey of Dreams.
All right, so they're going to give me hints, too, because I'm playing badly, but whatever.
Like, you suck. Let us help.
Well, I mean, I got C and
it's
everything.
Like the super
That's
guide.
The goal. So
how many worlds are there?
Claris has 4, and then the fifth one. Or, I'm sorry, that last she has 3, and then the final one they do together.
Okay. And then there's Elliot.
And then, yeah, we'll play Elliot.
Okay.
We can't actually do the final stage until we go back with Elliot.
Okay.
Oh, wait, no, never mind. We'll do our stage in the next.
I mean, it
stage.
Doesn't seem like this is a long game. Oh, wow.
They took my idea.
Okay, so that was supposed to happen.
Yeah. That'll happen before every stage. But again, the only one that they can't take is my courage. Which
they
I
will
have.
Never be able to take your courage.
So we combine with knights, and then we are off.
This is like the definition of a cult hit, this game. A lot of Sega games kind of are, because they
have
don't,
a unique flavor.
They
like
never,
Crazy Taxi, a lot of people
I
like.
I really like Crazy Taxi. I played it in the arcade.
That's another Sega cult hit.
But the
it
thing is,
the arcade by storm.
The Sega franchises are, they're very underrated. There's some really good things. Like a lot of people say, you know, Crazy Taxi.
Whoops, I missed
I
the
played
ball.
Crazy Hello. Taxi in the arcade, because it's at a movie theater around where we live, and there's few things that are more exhilarating than playing Crazy Taxi and with a steering wheel in the arcade.
Bonus time, begin.
Especially when you start and you just hear yeah 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 yeah, because it's
that's
just
always gonna be the Crazy Taxi.
The re-releases, they couldn't get the license for the Offspring or Bad Religion, and it's
of
just not,
not
the same. It's not the same. Come on.
We're just gonna go ahead and go to the next stage.
A lot of Sega series, Choo Choo Rocket, Fantasy Star.
Choo Choo Rocket's another one that a lot of people like.
Fantasy Star, Space
Channel
5.
I always
like
Fantasy Star Online.
Like everyone, Super Monkey Ball is another really great
one.
Yeah,
a lot of people like that game.
Super Monkey Ball is great, and I think that, you know, even when they start, when Sega stopped making consoles and Super Monkey Ball came to, like, the GameCube, those were really good games. They were pretty hard, but they were good. I think Sega has a, you know, some people say Sega franchise. Sega has no franchises besides Sonic, and I'm like, not
no,
really.
They have Knights.
That's
they,
why Sega Superstars.
They choose 10. Not to use a lot of their franchises, though.
Yeah,
which
it's
kind of
weird.
They currently only use Sonic.
Yeah, most of the games that Sega has been doing the best are, you know, like the Total War series.
The only thing Knights ever gets nowadays is cameo appearances in Sonic Lost World.
Yeah,
as
I mean,
DLC.
One thing is that Sega published, you know, they, for a while, they were publishing some really cool games. They originally published Bayonetta and a lot of other early Platinum games like Mad World and Vanquish. And for some reason, they haven't released Vanquish or Bayonetta on PC. And I'm thinking, you know how good that would be at 60 frames a second, Bayonetta?
C rank?
And
as
Vanquish?
As long as you don't get a D, we'll be good.
Yeah, I think you'll be fine. I just think that this game is just so energetic, and for a while I'm just like, what is this? And it's because it was on Sega Saturn. Sega Saturn really didn't have any standout software. I mean, it had the first
Oops,
Virtua Fighter, which was the first.
So this is a secret area, kind of.
Oh, yeah.
Where you can kind of go through this Donkey Kong style.
This music's really good, too. I know you can't really hear it, but it's good.
Large
it's really
loop.
Good. It's,
Look how many Link I got. 25
yeah,
Link in there.
Yeah.
I don't want to spend too much time in here, though, because there's no blue chips in this area.
Right, and you need those to keep your time going.
No, I need those to get the idea.
Yeah.
They changed
this
the...
This is some really interesting level design, because it feels very roller coaster-esque, but it still feels open.
Yeah.
It guides you in a certain
way. I can only go
way.
In one direction. I can go left or I can go right.
Yeah, but you can kind of loop and go back around. It just feels so free.
I'm not going to go in it this time. because I'm kind of running low on time now.
Yeah. Feels, you know, like, I'm Yuji Naka, Yuji Naka is the reason that I play games. He made Sonic, and Sonic 1, 2, 3, and Knuckles were the games that really got me into gaming. I can't remember which one I played first, but those were the ones that just, you know, Sonic 3 and Knuckles is a game I can still enjoy to this day. It's just as fun to play, if not more fun, than when I was a kid. So I have a lot of respect for Yuji Naka, and one thing that recently Yuji Naka finally released Rodea the Sky Soldier, which is a game that came out for the Wii and
running
the Wii
out of time,
U.
Running out of time. Oh, we made it.
he released Rodea the Sky Soldier.
Ooh,
is a new game that
didn't even try for that.
This is very similar to. It's a lot about flying, but Rodea got really bad reviews.
Did it?
Like, not good at all. So it kind of bums me out that a game.
I want to try it. If it has,
I mean, yeah,
it's
I mean,
usually not a flying game. I think it might control like NiGHTS, and I might really
well
enjoy
maybe.
It.
I think we can rent it because our local chain offers rentals.
What consoles is that on?
Wii and Wii U.
Wii U.
Yes, which
okay,
is weird.
Interesting. Yeah. That's
okay, so now we're kind of top down.
And now we're isometric a little bit. Some top down.
Yeah.
3D.
Top down flying.
In the prison for the blue chips is actually. Or for the idea is actually in the.
This is a really smart use of camera.
Oh no, go back!
It's a little.
No, I can't.
It's
I can't
a
go back.
Little weird. And you can kind of ricochet off surfaces.
Oh yep, I can go back. Cool.
What were you trying to do?
I want to go get the idea.
Oh okay.
Here. They kind of hide it in that corner area.
Yeah, I'm gonna be honest. This is kind of confusing, and I think I may need to. Because this is before tutorials, right?
Yeah.
So you kind
of
gotta.
And a lot of this lore comes from like instruction manual and.
Yeah, back when instruction manuals were a thing.
Yeah.
Ah, those were the days. Now we just have promotional.
But the
pamphlets.
Things in the Archie comics don't count, so no.
Yeah,
oh.
Archie comics are not canon, Matt. They do not exist. Sad AM sucks.
Sad AM isn't Archie.
The comics are. They're based on the comics. They're Archie comics.
The Archie comics came after.
Well, they continued, weren't they? I have no idea. I have no fucking idea. I don't track that nonsense.
Well, we need to get out of here.
Yeah, you better hurry. You got 15 seconds. Oh.
Oh, no. We might get a D on this one.
Well, that's still passing,
isn't it? I don't know how to get out. No, it's not. We have to get C's. I don't know how to get out of here. We're going to lose all our blue chips, too.
Oh, man.
How do I get out of here? I'm stuck. Okay, here we go. Oh, I found the exit, but we're fucked.
Well, now what? Now what happens?
We have to go follow the arrow to the knight's chamber.
And then you gotta get him again.
No, we already have the idea. I was just trying to get back to the chamber.
Okay, so, like, did
we'll get a D or an F on this part
of the
course.
Not the whole thing.
Not the whole thing, no. Okay, well, yeah, we got an F on that part. So hopefully with the boss bonus, we'll still get a C.
Because
I got a B on one of the other things.
Yeah, so you're still...
We might have to redo this stage.
Maybe. I think... I don't know.
Oh, this is one of the harder bosses, too.
Well, push it. Clutch.
I don't think we got this one.
I don't know.
I think I fucked it up.
Well, we'll cut it if we have to, but I think you'll be fine. You never know. The B surprised you. God, this is such a... Such colors. Like, I miss
all the bosses are very, very unique as well.
Like...
I remember this boss's name.
The models may not be that in-depth, but like not even games these days really have this kind of color.
He's too high for me to hit right now.
I like the blue.
I can't touch them when he's got the aura on them.
Yeah.
That's okay. Bullshit. I had no control of my character there.
So you gotta do the whole thing in one run. That's pretty tense. Like those two-dimensional clownfish.
I can change the stage.
Okay. Alright.
Got him.
Did you get him? Sweet. Nice job. Oh, nice. Oh, he's all deflated.
And I can use the triggers to, like, twirl.
Let's see how well you did. I don't know. It seems like you kind of did that pretty quick.
I did, but could have been better.
Oh,
new record.
Oh,
we got the C.
Hell
yeah, we don't have to redo the stage.
Hell yeah.
Woo, I was worried about that one. By the way, each of the characters don't go to the same stages.
That's really cool.
They have.
Oh yeah, you beat out Sonic and Knuckles and Amy on the leaderboards.
The only stages that they share are the final stage, which we are one level away for unlocking for Claris.
It's not that long, but I think that judging at how
the
intricate the levels
are. You would
go
back to play those stages. I don't know if you noticed, but every single one of those we've gotten a C so far.
Yeah.
Getting an A rank
is hard.
This is one of my favorite stages. Final stage is my favorite stage. And you'll see why. I'll explain it.
All right.
But this stage is my second favorite because look at the environment here. It's like all soft and plush.
Yeah. Oh, God, that's cool.
Everything's plush here. Which is very fitting for a dream for this girl to be having because it's like, oh, it's a... I mean, that sounds sexist, but...
No,
it's the
not,
kind of
not
thing
really.
That a character
it's
looks
a kid.
This way. A little girl would probably dream this.
Yeah, I think that's fair to say. I mean, you know, This is a pretty inspirational game. I mean, after us playing like games like The Walking Dead that makes us feel like shit, it's kind of nice to play a game that...
This is a feel-good game.
Totally
it's
feel
great.
Good. I like feel-good games. I mean, like, there's like...
I play this whenever I'm sad.
Yeah.
It makes me feel better.
I play other games when I'm... I don't play Bloodborne.
Bloodborne's not really a game to play.
That's not a... I get mad when I play
Bloodborne. Bonus time, yeah.
Yeah, push
it. I'm just gonna go straight to the fucking thing.
Okay.
Boy?
Well, oh my god, the environments feel so unique. I mean, that's
every single one.
That's
they all
really
have their own
cool.
Unique colors and song.
Yeah, this is
and
a game
they don't
that
share between.
This is if this game was like released
we played
today.
Christmas Nights for Christmas. Spoilers, we're doing that.
Yeah, we're good. Yeah, that's one reason why we kind of wanted to get this done this year.
They share their the same what do you call it? They share the same level in that, but
Ooh.
You have to beat it with both characters in order to unlock
Ooh.
The. Ending because it actually does have a story, and we have to play Nights before that because that story has spoilers.
Right. Well, also I don't think it's unlocked yet, right?
No, it's not.
I know it's on this release. I'm pretty sure anyway.
All right, I got a C. That's great.
I think I double checked it earlier today. God.
This
is
unique.
Now it's sort of like
this is like a bounce castle here.
Oh, that's so cool.
So like we bounce through all this.
That's
shit.
That's really neat.
And Nights actually controls differently. I'm bouncing. I'm not flying.
Why did he look like he was fat?
Yeah, he when he bounces, he kind of inflates a little bit.
That's silly. That's really interesting. Oh, this is such a Yuji Naka game.
And the final boss, or not the final boss, but the boss of this stage is designed based on this bounce mechanic.
That's super cool.
Alright, we have plenty of blue chips now.
I think like there really haven't been many games I've seen that you really use color interestingly. I mean, the only game I think that this sort of reminds me from an aesthetic standpoint is like the bosses in Splatoon.
Yeah, they do.
They
have
they,
a lot of color.
They have a lot of energy. They have a lot of they use the. This is just I mean, I can't even pinpoint the kind of aesthetic. This feels just like a storybook. This is like a storybook. It's super nice.
Twing!
Aw, ka-ching. Woo!
B. That'd be pretty good.
B is for...
For only going through one time around the course.
Yeah.
Ooh, metal.
I'm trying to remember who did the music for this game. I feel like... Oh, that's cool.
Doink.
Oh, that's good. Oh, now you're kind of controlling it like a Star Fox.
Boink. Boink.
These sort of feel like level gimmicks, but they don't sort of don't.
They like, don't they're like gimmicks. They're definitely the game's aesthetic.
I like games that use I like games that use these sort of aesthetics and as far as a level design thing. It's like why I liked Kirby's Epic Yarn did this really well, because the yarn was it you were able to create levels and you had to keep the yarn in mind.
We're just gonna go straight back into the fucking
I think games that do that are great.
Got another C. All right, time for Nightmare Course 4.
Ooh, dun 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 dun.
So this we're kind of going back to a bounce castle, but now look at this shit.
Oh, wow.
We can only see the loops and the reflections now.
That's so cool. That's such a creative idea. I think that doesn't seem... Like, this was... You know, Sega was just coming off the Genesis, whose music...
Yeah, no one's really done 3D at this point.
Well, the music in the Genesis was always very hard-edged. It was very metal, very industrial. It had that booming Skrillex bass. But...
I'm missing one chip. Are you kidding
me? But compared to, where do you go? Where'd you miss it?
I don't know.
Well, it's in the course.
There's extra chips, so...
It's in the course, so... I don't know what you're looking for, so I can't really help you. Oh, God. Can you get it in time?
We're not going to do the whole course again. Okay. I'm going to just go backwards.
All right. And you can twirl. Woo!
Yeah, I have a special meter that I can do that with. Honestly, a little pro tip. We're not going for it this time because it's a lot harder and it'll take me more time because I'll have to, like, retry a bunch.
Yeah.
But if you hold the A button down and you constantly are getting chain, you can... Finally...
Are you
whatever,
this
fuck. Way? It's fine.
I don't know what you're looking for, so I'm kind of not sure.
We already got what we were looking for. I just was an idiot and didn't go into the thing.
Push it. Push the limit.
So basically, if you keep getting Link, your bar will never run out, and you can do the entire stage like this.
Oh, that's cool.
Which is a lot faster, and you can keep your Link going easier that way.
Sweet.
The only downside is it's harder to control because...
Because it's faster.
The turn radius is, like, non-existent. You can't turn in that mode.
All right, time to take on a boss.
Okay, so this is... Oh, shit.
It's a jester.
This is Jackal.
Jackal. He's a jester.
I believe his name is Jackal anyway. I might be wrong.
Watch out for his devil cards.
So we keep hitting these cards. Okay, got him. So we have to keep him out of his cloak.
Oh, yeah. So you just gotta get him. Did you get him?
Yep.
Okay. Alright. Oh, is that his meter down there?
Stay away from your cloak. Gotta keep him naked. My meter is down there.
Oh, okay. I was wondering.
That's my spin meter.
What?
One more time.
Got that Kefka thing going on.
He's dead.
Nice.
69 seconds left. Hells yeah.
Bow, chicka, bow, bow.
I like these spinny dances you can do with the... And that's the signature dance he does when the game ends.
Yeah, I mean, this game's music seems a lot more, lighthearted. Not as hard as... It kinda,
listen to this track.
It seems a lot more
wait
like
till you
Mario.
Hear the ending credits cinematic music.
Oh, yeah.
Just wait.
Fuck you, Sonic.
It has the signature...
Miles. Beat Miles.
To everyone who calls Tails, that's not his name. His name is Miles.
Miles Tails.
Miles...
Miles
per hour.
That's a horrible pun. You
his
should be
first name is Miles.
Sega.
His second name is Prower. P-W-R-O-R.
Tails is his nickname.
Like Tails is his nickname is Tails.
Yeah, like everyone knows that.
I should say Miles' nickname is Tails.
Miles.
So this is the final level.
I hate it.
Called Twin Seeds.
Twin Seeds.
They live in Twin Seeds City, and they're on Twin Seeds Tower. That's the tower that Knights is trapped in right now, is Twin Seeds Tower.
Yeah, so this level
so
looks a lot
this time,
different.
They actually took my idea of courage. Because Wise Man did it himself.
Right. Oh, wow.
So I'm here with nothing. I have this platform, and that's it.
How are you going to get Knights?
I have to be brave. And jump.
Oh, really? Oh. Oh, that's cool. So now you have to do it on your own.
I got my idea of courage back, and using my own power of lucid dreaming,
that's super
I'm
cool.
I'm overcoming my own nightmare on my own abilities, not Knights'.
Ah, that's really good.
And she, unlike Knights, doesn't have the she doesn't have Knights's nightmare in power, which is the power of Paraloop. But she does.
What's her special move?
Her special power. Is that things are gravitating towards her.
Oh, that's cool.
See how they're kind of absorbing?
Mm-hmm.
So instead of paralooping things, I can just fly near them and they'll go into her.
Oh, wow.
Now, the reason that this stage is kind of hard is because there's only 20 chips. If you miss them, you're fucked.
Okay.
And they are different courses, but they all share the same timer. Before, we were...
So you just have to complete all of these.
Before the
timer
would
reset
each course.
Yeah.
This one, you get one timer for the entire thing.
Okay.
But the reason I like the stage so much is because it's so cinematic and you have to face your fears and jump off.
Yeah, I think that's a very good thematic...
Oops, I didn't mean to hit that. That's going to fuck me up later. Oh well.
That's,
I got the things.
That's a lot like...
the Knuckles thing in Sonic 3, where Knuckles is kind of like...
Oh no, I mean...
All of a sudden he's your ally.
I just think that the facing your fears and having to do that, that's great. I think that's a really good wow, A rank, nice. Connection with the player. I mean, that makes sense. That, you know, that's the antithesis of ludonarrative dissonance. That's ludonarrative cognizance. It makes sense for the player, and it also makes sense for the character. Works very well.
I missed a lot of chips. That's okay.
Oh man,
we'll get them.
Do it. You can do it. You just don't run out of time. Oh wow. God, this is... Oh, man.
I was going very fast there.
Yeah, you were. I was like, geez, you're going fast,
That's
man.
Hard to... That looked easy. That was fucking hard as shit.
No, I believe it. I believe it.
The controls are very floaty. I'll let you play it a little bit after this, yeah. Just so you get a feel for how floaty it is. It's floaty as fuck.
B-rank.
But that's not necessarily a bad thing.
Can you get there? You got 30 seconds. Strength. Oh, man. It's gonna be clutch.
It's going to be down to the wire. I expected it to be.
Oh,
no,
man.
These balloons will fuck me.
Ugh. Oh, man, I don't think you're going to make it. I'm going to have to push it. Oh, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I didn't make it.
You didn't miss.
I was right there. I was very close.
Night over. That's okay. We'll redo that one.
Yeah, we'll just cut to me doing it, I guess.
It's just, you just gotta... What messed you up there?
I kind of grabbed onto that... When I hit that spike?
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, that's gonna fuck me up later? That took off 5 whole seconds.
Yeah, we
if
might...
If I didn't lose that, yeah. I would have been...
We might just keep that. I don't know. Depends.
Depends on how long this part is.
Yeah.
If you feel like you need to cut it, then cut it.
Yeah.
Otherwise, hey, welcome to kind of the back scenes, behind the scenes
yeah.
here.
Blooper reel.
20 Link.
No, Let's Plays don't have blooper reels.
They could. We can start that.
Trend. Nah, because then it's like things that if we fuck up, like if the game glitches or something.
These balloons also fuck with you because they're pulling me off the track.
Right.
Fuck you.
Push the limit. Oh, wow. Nice. A rank! Yeah, kind of having it all on one timer is kind of...
That's the hardest part of the stage.
Ding, ding, ding. That Link. Dat Link. Ooh. Oh, can't go through. Oh, wow. How'd you do that?
I sped.
Okay. Super Link. You almost got them all.
Who's to say I didn't?
Oh, never mind.
Wait, where's the... I thought I saw the thing that I was looking for. Fuck, where did it go?
Is it down?
Oh, it's... Fuck.
Where is it?
I saw it. I know I did. Where the fuck is it? Fuck it. All right. Oh, there it is. Damn it. Oh, it's in the foreground. I'm not on that track yet. Fuck. There it is. That's what I was looking for.
Okay.
We wasted a lot of time, though.
Yeah.
It'll be fine.
Just gotta hurry. This is the third of four, right?
Yeah.
It's pretty crazy how you know where... You know, because this is one track. Like, something's in the foreground, something's in the background. I just can't imagine how you're able to...
You get a feel for it. Because you know that you can only go directly in front of you, not, like,
right,
at angles.
Yeah.
Sometimes, oops, I fucked that up this time. It's not going to be as cool. Oh, well.
Just finish the level. I think that's all that matters.
Right, we got enough.
Oh, man.
I got it.
I hope you do. Jesus. Thank you, Christ.
All right, time to go to the final,
You got 30 seconds. Push the limit. Watch out for those stupid bullshit balloons. Oh. Whoa.
Alright, we got enough.
You just need to get to the...
You just need to get to the thing.
Hail,
time.
Yeah. Wow.
So we have our idea, but Wise Man put a barrier around Knights, so we can't get to him.
No, we must save Knights.
I'm not strong enough. I need help. Oh, shit! It's Elliot! But they these characters, Elliot and Claris, never met in real life.
Yeah.
They only met in their dream.
Through Knights.
They only met in their lucid dream.
That's pretty crazy.
Oh. That'll come into play later.
Yeah, that's really good.
Thank you.
Three A's and a B?
Mm-hmm.
That's good.
I have a chance to make this whole thing an A. Now there's two Knights. We both dualize with them.
Oh, wow.
And we're going to need both of us to stop Wise Man.
The bosses are
this
really
is Wise Man
cool
the Wicked.
Designed. Oh.
We need both Knightses to get through the barrier.
Then what? Oh, okay. That happened,
Phase
I guess.
Two.
Whoa. Careful. That's some bullet hell shit.
A little bit.
Careful. Oh, God.
I thought I had enough time.
Oh. Alright. Okay.
This one's the sucky one. Oh, no, never mind. The sucky one's coming up next.
I like how the whole background changes mm-hmm. so dramatically.
This one is the one that sucks the most because you have to. You see that little. I have to
thread
the needle.
Oh, my God. Are you kidding?
I have to thread the needle.
Oh. You apparently did it.
It's. We did it.
Yay!
Usually we'll. You think that you float through the very middle of it, but you didn't. And
that's
it knocks
crazy.
You back. And I'm pretty sure it also takes off 5 seconds in addition to knocking
you
back.
Oh man, that's horrible. But you did it. Yay, you defeated Wise Man. Woo! Well, now you gotta do Elliot's turn. Oh, hi, Knights. Thank you, Knights.
He's gonna leave us now because we don't need him anymore.
Yeah,
he's helped us.
The growth.
That's one of the names of the idea. There's like growth, knowledge, power, I think, is one.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Courage. There's 5 in total, I think.
Yeah.
So it's addition day.
Ooh, can you do it? Can you face your nightmare?
Does she have the power to change her destiny?
Yeah.
So far, this is playing out exactly like her dream.
Yeah, so she's
worried
nervous.
About it.
That's just such a good story.
But it's okay, because she remembers her friend Knights that she met.
Yeah. The character design is so that era.
It's true. Early 90s.
It's like
the director's
like
oh
the
my god
stuff. Like wow.
And this is the animations look very stiff, but this is because
nah, this looks really good for
3 hadn't
the
been done before.
This looks better than like what Final Fantasy VII looked like.
Yeah.
Like
but,
these
I
look
mean,
like real like you know,
no
like,
one had done 3D. No one knew how to do it. Sonic at this point had Sonic 3D Blast, but that wasn't really 3D.
Well, I mean, like judging from a cinematic standpoint and judging from a gameplay standpoint was good. Super Mario 64 was really the one that introduced a controllable camera, which you kind of needed in a 3D space.
So this is where Knights is officially like, okay.
Nice work.
We did it.
Oh, no.
He's got to leave you now. And she's like, no.
No, Knights.
You're strong on your own now.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that was Claris.
So now there's another story.
But we're not done yet. We gotta go to New Game Plus and play Elliot.
New Game Plus?
Dedicated to the players and developers of the original game.
So you're
Yay,
in there.
That's me! I'm on the credits!
You made this game?
No, I'm,
okay.
It's
yeah,
dedicated to me.
Sonic Team.
Original version created by Sonic Team. So this is the...
That's
a
good ending theme.
This is the ending theme here.
Yosuke Okunari, Makoto Uchida.
These are the people from the remake, I believe.
Yeah.
These are clearly Japanese kids singing
English.
That's
fine. We should skip these. Because we're going to be starting
because there's
the
kind of like... In the slideshow, there's Claris and Claire.
Oh, okay. Yeah, we'll keep going then.
Plus,
those
I mean,
don't look like Japanese names.
Some of them aren't.
Some of those look like Chinese names.
Way to be racist, Jesus. There's the Nightopians.
No, like the language. Like
this will also put the... We'll skip the credit sequence on Elliot's ending thing. So that's Shleep.
Shleep.
You saw a bunch of those guys. It's cool seeing a lot of the environment artworks. There's Cruelly and Pole.
I do like those sort of, I guess they call them character parades, where they show all of the characters.
Yeah, Donkey Kong does that.
Donkey Kong Country did that. Banjo-Kazooie does that.
Mario 2 did that, I think. Party.
I like that. I don't know why. I just kind of like seeing the names of all the characters and the different enemies in the game.
I'm usually mostly interested in knowing what the boss names are. Like in Zelda, I know the snakes are ropes and the bats are keys.
Yeah, that requires a...
Veril.
Prior to the internet, it required the instruction manual.
Which I had.
Yeah.
Gao. Those ones, they can stun you with their little electric zappies. I don't think we saw any of those.
Yeah, I don't remember.
We'll see them in the mountain area with Elliot. But you'll see when we play Elliot, his environments are unique. They're very different. Cuddle.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a cuttlefish. Looks like the boss from Splatoon.
Yeah, it kind of does.
Kirkle. We'll see a lot more of those in Elliot's as well. Those guys are assholes because they'll grab Knight's feet and pull him down. So it takes up your time. It takes up a full 5 seconds just doing that. And then it takes 5 seconds off your timer. So it... Snip. We didn't see much of those.
These character designs are very, very artistic.
They are. Hollow.
Very carnivalesque.
There's a reason for that.
Right. Like Kefka. Kefka looks like a freaking character from The Hunger Games.
Kinda. So, Elliot fights harder bosses, one of them being Rila, which is Wise Man the Wicked's left hand.
Hmm.
So him and Knights together were like number one in Wise Man's Army of Nightmares.
Yeah.
And he was going to use both of them to take over the world, but Knights doesn't want to. Okay, here's the bosses. There's Gilwing. He's actually, I think, my favorite boss in this game, Gilwing.
Mm-hmm.
In terms of design and where you fight him. Puffy, we didn't see her. She'll be in Elliot's Nightmares.
That's a weird-ass design.
Don't worry about it. Gulpo. That's the fish.
Mm-hmm.
I knew it was something to do with eating. But
Yuji Naka-san.
Yuji Naka. Special thank you. Claws.
Yeah,
we didn't fight him
this
either.
This was his game.
We didn't fight Claws. His fight sucks. I don't like it. It's not as bad as Rila's, though. Rila's is the worst fight in the game. There's Jekyll. I was right. It is Jekyll. I wasn't sure. Rila. We didn't fight him.
Yeah, I think I remember seeing that in
Rila doesn't have the gender either, even though he's mostly masculine.
Yeah, whatever.
Wise Man, the Wicked.
Oh, his character designs are super good. And Knights?
Wait for Knights. You gotta wait. Brace for impact. There he is. Knights.
Hi, Knights.
Presented by Sega.
That's a cool character design.
Thank you for playing. Try Elliot's Dream. It's different.
Okay.
We promise.
We will. On the next episode.
Oh, shit. Hang on, there's another thing.
All right.
We're not done yet.
Oh.
That was a good day, right?
And she didn't make it. The audition didn't work.
No, it did work.
Yeah, I know they liked it, and then they changed their mind.
No.
That's a very
so
iconic...
So there's a reason we played Claris first.
Why?
If you play Elliot first and then Claris, you have to go back and play Elliot's again to get the true ending.
That's stupid.
I think. I'm pretty sure.
They shouldn't let you do that.
So that was it.
That's like those achievements that say do easy mode and then you do hard mode and you don't get the achievements for easy mode.
Right.
That's why you should always
me.
Do like hard
or
easy.
So we got three
easier.
New stages to do with Elliot and then the final boss again.
All right.
So we will see you guys on the next one.